Hi, it's me, Dr. Prasad Patelam, continuing my classes on organic chemistry. This particular video class is for methods of determining reaction mechanism, mainly kinetic and non-kinetic. In this, I am explaining how to propose a reaction mechanism by identification and detection of final products, kinetic and thermodynamically controlled reactions, a study of intermediates, and trapping of intermediates. We know that most of the organic reaction or all organic reactions, it involves the cleavage of more than one covalent bond and subsequent formation of new covalent bonds, which is mainly due to the movement of electrons, or we call it as electron displacement effects. On the basis of this cleavage of bonds, organic reactions can be categorized or classified as catalytic bond cleavage mechanism, homolytic bond cleavage, or even pericyclic reaction mechanisms. In heterolytic bond cleavage mechanism, the covalent bond, it is broken in such a way that, as given in the image representation, atom A is connected to atom B through a covalent bond. And if the bond cleavage is heterolytic, that is, the electrons moves completely towards B, since it may be more electronegative atom, the obtained intermediate in which atom B is having the two electrons, or it gets negative charge, and atom A get positive charge. That means in this type of cleavage, the electrons remain with one of the fragment. So this type of reaction mechanism, there is no need of an ionic intermediate, but in most of the cases, ionic intermediates are also involved. In homolytic bond cleavage mechanism, a covalent bond breaks in such a way that each fragments get one electron each. That means it becomes a free radical. So atom A is connected to atom B, both are having almost same electronegativity, such a way that the electron displacement breaks and each atom gets its own electron. It becomes a free radical. In pericyclic reaction mechanism, the electron movement is within the closed ring, and there are no further intermediates are formed. These are rearranged mechanism, and the final product is obtained by the movement of electrons in a closed ring. One of the examples is given here. Now, kinetic and non-kinetic methods. In kinetic method, it involves the measurement of some parameters, kinetic parameters like order of a reaction, a rate law, a rate constant, or even kinetic isotope effects are involved. Whereas in non-kinetic method, here mainly the concept of electron displacement effect, as well as some of the evidences obtained are used to finalize the reaction mechanism or to propose the reaction mechanism. That means when a new reaction is discovered, more than one reaction mechanisms are proposed based on the concept of electron displacement effect, and the best mechanism which suits to the evidences are considered or finalized as the reaction mechanism for that. So these proposed mechanism may not provide the complete information like the structure of the molecule or energy involved in the reaction or even stereochemistry. And this reaction mechanism may change as new discoveries happen. However, most of the reaction mechanism proposed by non-kinetic methods are best, and it explains all the experimental data. The methods used in non-kinetic reaction mechanism are some of them are identification and determination of the product, detection and study of the intermediate formed, isotopic labeling, stereochemical evidences, and crossover experiments. First one, that is identification and detection of product. Based on the quality and quantity of the product or products obtained, a proper reaction mechanism can be proposed, starting from the substrate, that is the one which react, and with the reagents, solvents, and the reaction conditions which are maintained. Some of the examples, if I say, first one, that is Markovnikov's addition and anti-Markovnikov's addition reactions. The first case, when an unsymmetric alkene, say example propene. Propene is an unsymmetric alkene because the double bond each carbon, the doubly bonded carbon atom are not having the same substituents. Therefore, we call it as unsymmetric alkene. If it reacts with HBr, the final product obtained is 2-bromopropane, or the major product is 2-bromopropane and not 1-bromopropane. So this is an example for Markovnikov's addition. Its mechanism can be explained with the formation of a carbocation as intermediate. So here the HBr, hydrogen is connected to bromine through a covalent bond. It breaks heterolytically such that bromine will get two electrons or negative charge. H will become positively charged. the positively charged hydrogen of HBr will be attracted towards the electron density of the pi electrons or the double bond present in the propene, and the attack of the H plus takes such a way that we'll get a carbocation which is more stable. So there are possibility of two carbocation here, a primary carbocation as well as a secondary carbocation. A secondary carbocation is more stable, therefore that will be the intermediate formed. That means the H plus will be added to the carbon having more number of hydrogen atoms. So the obtained carbocation is indicated here, which will be attacked by the Br minus. Br minus will be attacking and will be getting the final product as 2-bromopropane. So this is Markovnikov's addition or Markovnikov's proposed reaction mechanism to obtain the final product. So based on the product, the reaction mechanism is proposed. Whereas if an unsymmetric alkene, say the same propene, reacts with HBr in presence of traces of peroxide, the final product obtained is not 2-bromopropane, it is 1-bromopropane. Its mechanism is explained as a free radical mechanism, and it is an anti-Markovnikov's addition reaction. It's example for anti-Markovnikov's addition. So here initially the peroxide dissociate in presence of sunlight or heat to become the corresponding free radical. Here it is alkoxy free radical. The alkoxy free radical further reacts with the hydrogen bromide. Here the hydrogen bromide HBr bond breaks homolytically such a way that we'll be getting a halide free radical. The halide free radical further attacks the unsymmetric alkene. So here the halide radical will attack or will connect to the carbon, which is less sterically hindered, having less having the atoms of rupa which are less bulkier. So here the carbon is connected to two hydrogen which is less bulkier, whereas the second carbon which is presented here, which is having an alkyl substitution, that means it is bulkier. Therefore Br will be connecting to the carbon which is containing the atoms which are less bulkier and forms the corresponding alkyl free radical. Now this alkyl free radical further reacts with HBr, another homolytic break happens or homolytic cleavage happens, free radical mechanism continues, and we'll get the final product as 1-bromopropane. Another example, that is chlorination. I took three examples: chlorination of methane in presence of sunlight, chlorination of toluene with chlorine in vapor phase, and chlorination of toluene with chlorine in liquid phase. That liquid phase may contains a ferric chloride, can be taken as the example. So first case, in methane in presence of sunlight, the produce the obtained products are a mixture of ethane along with chloromethane, dichloromethane, trichloromethane and tetrachloromethane. So a mixture of these products are obtained. Therefore the proposed reaction mechanism for to obtain these products are free radical mechanism. So free radical mechanism in which the chlorine Cl bond in presence of energy or sunlight breaks homolytically such a that we'll get two molecules of or two chlorine free radicals. This is known as initiation. Then the propagation or chain reaction takes place. The methane molecule reacts with the chlorine free radical. The homolytic cleavage of CH bond break happens such a way that we'll get a carbon free radical, which further reacts with the chlorine molecule. Another set of homolytic cleavage happens, and we'll get the corresponding chloromethane. The chloromethane further it continues the same way, it continues to react to give dichloromethane as well as tetrachloro. Methane. The termination, how the reaction can end. So the possible termination reactions are also given here. Two chlorine free radicals can combine to give chlorine molecule, or chlorine free radical combined with carbon with the free radical to become the corresponding alkyl halide, or two alkyl free radical can combine to give corresponding higher alkane. So these proposed mechanism suits the formation of a mixture of products. Whereas in the reaction of toluene with chlorine in vapor phase gives a benzyl chloride. This also can be explained, it's similar to that of a free radical mechanism explained in previous slide. The reaction of toluene with chlorine in liquid phase, that is in presence of ferric chloride as an example, it gives a mixture of orthochlorotoluene and parachlorotoluene, which are an example for electrophilic substitution reaction. Okay, the electrophile formed here it can be represented like this. The chlorine molecule combines with or reacts with ferric chloride to give chlorine with a positive charge, which acts as a electrophile. The electrophile attacks the benzene ring. Since toluene contains CH3 group, which is an ortho para defecting, which is already explained in my previous video, the ortho and para positions will be attacked by the chlorine with a positive charge. Therefore, we'll be obtaining the corresponding ortho chloro toluene as well as para chloro toluene. Another example, that is reaction with potassium cyanide, KCN. Benzyl chloride reacts with KCN to form benzyl cyanide, whereas furfural chloride reacts with potassium cyanide to form 5-cyanofuryl chloride. So here both benzyl chloride as well as furfural chloride, both are aromatic in nature, looks similar, but the attack of KCN, the final product obtained, are different. Therefore, a suitable mechanism can be proposed based on that. Another one, that is reaction of sodamide and liquid ammonia to chlorobenzene, which we call as amination reaction. The chlorobenzene reacts with the sodamide and liquid ammonia to give aniline. So here it is a simple substitution reaction. The chlorine is substituted with NH2, amine group. Whereas if the ortho position contains an iodo methoxy group or with iodine as the main halide, or even chlorine as the halide, that means if ortho iodo anisole or ortho chloro anisole reacts with the same reagent, sodamide and liquid ammonia, it gives a 50-50 ratio mixture of ortho amino anisole and meta amino anisole. So here this is not a simple substitution reaction as we seen in the previous case. Here the reaction intermediate is a benzene is formed as a reaction intermediate. So it can be explained, the reaction mechanism, it involves benzene as intermediate, and we can split the reaction mechanism as step 1 and step 2. In step 1, a formation of benzene intermediate takes place, that means a sodamide NaNH2, which ionizes to give Na plus and NH2 minus. The NH2 minus takes one proton or H plus H from the benzene molecule, and the subsequent removal of iodine here, iodide, the halide is removed, and we'll be getting a corresponding intermediate. The intermediate is benzene intermediate, which is also explained in my previous videos. So this benzene intermediate, the attack can be taken in two positions. Therefore, step 2 reaction with A, step 2A reaction, if attack of ammonia NH3 happens in this given fashion, we'll be getting ortho amino anisole. Or if the attack of NH3 happens in this particular fashion, then we'll be getting the corresponding meta amino anisole. So this benzene intermediate explains the formation of ortho amino anisole as well as meta amino anisole. Next one, that is kinetic and thermodynamic controlled product formation. Say if you take an example, of a mixture of 0.01 mole of cyclohexanone, furfural and semi-carbazide. The reaction can be schematically represented like this. A cyclohexanone reacts with the furfural in presence of semi-carbazide. In the initial stages or within a few seconds, the product obtained is cyclohexanone semi-carbazide. But after a few hours, the product formed will be changed to semi-carbazone. That is, initially the reaction is controlled kinetically, and later stages it is the thermodynamic control. Thermodynamic is related to temperature. Second one, that is a study of intermediate. Among all the possible methods, this is one of the best or convincing method, since we can, if we can separate the intermediate formed, then it is easy for one to propose the reaction mechanism. So one example, if I take a Hofmann rearrangement, in which almost all the intermediate can be isolated, means we can separate it and we can check which molecule, which compound is formed. So based on the intermediate formed, anyhow we can finalize the final product, or we can suggest the reaction mechanism to give the product formation. So here in case of Hofmann rearrangement, the N-bromamide as well as its anion and even isocyanate, or all the intermediate formed, it can be isolated and we can analyze the product formed. If some of the intermediate, it is not easily, we cannot even isolate, then even we can think about trapping the intermediate or using some other method to analyze the intermediate. Even the isolated intermediate, if you are able to isolate the intermediate, it should be distinguishable from the final product or any other side product formed. And the species isolated, it should also should be a true intermediate, or it should be in equilibrium with a true intermediate. If there is less stability of intermediate, then we cannot isolate the intermediate, and we cannot do this type of method to propose a reaction mechanism. In that, trapping the intermediate, that means if the intermediate are not easily isolated, you cannot isolate the intermediate easily, then we can think about using some physical techniques such as a spectroscopy method like ESR, NMR or IR, or even we can trap the intermediate. One of the examples is given here, trapping the intermediate carbene. What is carbene? That is already explained in my previous video. A carbene can be carbene can act as an intermediate during a reaction mechanism, and this carbene, it is not so easily you cannot isolate, but it can be trapped with say example cis-2-butene. The cis-2-butene molecule is represented here. It can be used to isolate, or can be used to trap the carbene which is formed, since the cis-2-butene reacts with the carbene to form a stable product, that is cyclopropane, or its derivatives. Next, that is crossover experiments, isotope labeling, and stereochemical and kinetic evidences will be explained in the next coming video. Thank you very much for watching my video.